Once you've made vegetables part of your diet, you're healthy, right? Not necessarily. Just because you eat vegetables regularly doesn't mean you're benefiting from all the nutrients they have to offer. There is a possibility you've been cooking your vegetables all wrong and absorbing little to no vitamins and fiber. Hi viewers, and welcome back to Bestie. Apart from impacting your nutritional health, the way you cook your vegetables can also have an effect on the flavor. And I mean that not in a good way. If you want to get the most nutritional bang for your calorie buck, how you prep and cook your vegetables will make a difference. And in today's video, we'll tell you the mistakes to avoid from not cooking them at all, boiling them too much, cooking when they're wet, under-seasoning them, to overcrowding the pan, and more. Watch until the end to learn about all of them. Number 1. Oiling the vegetables. Smothering your veggies in oil before you start cooking them may seem like a foolproof way to avoid them sticking to the pan. Unfortunately, adding oil to them increases the chances of the veggies getting burned because the oil will get extremely hot. Instead, add a thin layer of extra virgin olive oil to the pan and then add the veggies after. You won't have to worry about everything sticking to the pan or gross burnt vegetables. Which vegetables would you love to make part of your daily diet? Which ones do you avoid at all costs? We would love to know down in the comments below. Number 2. Not cooking them at all. While it's true that many vegetables are healthier in their raw state, it's not true for all of them. Beets, broccoli, onions, and bell peppers have more nutrients when raw, but others actually are more nutritious when heat is applied. Asparagus has cancer-fighting properties that get turned on when steamed. Mushrooms give you more potassium when they're sautéed, grilled, or roasted. While raw spinach tastes great in a salad, eating it cooked will let you absorb more calcium, iron, and magnesium. Likewise for tomatoes, you absorb more cancer-fighting lycopene when they're cooked. It's a good idea, then, to eat lots of raw veggies but enjoy some cooked in amazing recipes as well. Number 3. Prepping veggies too early. Some people like to get ahead and do tasks in advance rather than last minute. While that's a good trait for some things, it doesn't always work with vegetables. Once you wash and cut them, oxidation and nutrient loss begins, as well as wilting and spoilage. It's better to cut your veggies right before you use them. If you need to chop them in advance, do it no early than the morning or night before. The same goes for washing and prepping greens. Once you wash greens, they'll begin to wilt, so you should not wash them until you plan to use them. If you simply must wash them in advance, put them in a bag with a paper towel around them to absorb excess moisture. Number 4. Boiling them too much. Boiling may be a quick way to prepare veggies, but it's also a quick way to rid them of their nutrients and flavor. When you boil them, the water-soluble nutrients seep out of the veggies and into the cooking water. Boiling can also lead to overcooking, which will make them soft, gray, and mushy. The only time veggies should swim in boiling water is when you're making soup, and even then, only for a short time. If you blanch them in boiling water to soften them, do it only for a few minutes, and transfer them into an ice bath before they lose their bright color. Use other methods of cooking vegetables, such as steaming, sautéing, stir-frying, or grilling. Not only will the veggies be exposed to heat for a shorter period of time, but also these methods allow ample opportunity to add flavor and seasoning. Number 5. Overcrowding the pan. Sometimes when you're in a hurry, you may put too many vegetables on the pan for cooking. Crowding the pan results in the food steaming rather than caramelizing, searing, or getting crisp. Plus, when you add food into the oil, it drops the temperature of the oil. It isn't even cooking at its optimal temperature. When you put the entire bunch of string beans in the pan or wok at once, they're going to be soggy. Only put as many veggies as you can fit in a single layer with some room to spare around the pieces. If you have more veggies than that to cook, do it in several batches. Use the largest pan or wok you have. Number 6. Smoking out the veggies. While you may love the slightly burnt flavor that your grill lends to veggie kebabs, the hot and dry environment can deplete your produce's nutrients. What's worse, if you leave them on the grill long enough that they develop a blackened, charred appearance, that's a sign that the veggies could have been exposed to benzopyrene, a carcinogenic chemical found in cigarette smoke. Next time you're barbecuing outside, ditch the kebabs and cook your vegetables in a grill basket instead. This tactic eliminates the risk of eating dangerous char, while helping the veggies retain their moisture, vitamins, and minerals. Whipping up dinner indoors? Stick to medium-high cooking heat and skip the olive oil drizzle before heating your veggies. Cooking them dry and adding the fat after will help cut back on the antioxidant-depleting smoke. Number 7. You're tossing out the good parts. How many times have you chopped the stalk and leaves of your broccoli and tossed them into the trash? Or peeled off cucumber and potato skins? Don't be embarrassed if you do it quite often. It is a common error. But now's the time to change your ways and stop throwing out the healthiest parts of your veggies. Skins, leaves, and stalks have unique nutrients not found in other parts of the vegetables. They also have higher concentrations of vitamins than parts more commonly eaten. Step away from the peeler and chill with the chop and toss. Use broccoli stalks and leaves in stir fries, soups, and salads to get a hefty dose of health-boosting nutrients. Number 8. You're roasting at too low temperature. Perfectly roasted vegetables have the power to turn even the biggest haters into the number one fans. But if what you're pulling out of the oven isn't brown and crisp on the outside, tender and creamy on the inside, something's gone wrong, and it's probably the cooking temperature. 400 to 450 degrees is the sweet spot for most vegetables to obtain that delicious caramelized exterior while ensuring the inside is cooked through. Optimal oven temperature isn't the only factor to pay attention to when roasting veggies. You also have to put them in the right pan. Baking sheets are the perfect pan for roasting veggies because of their low sides. Anything too high will prevent water from evaporating, which could lead to soggy veggies. Number 9. Cooking vegetables when they're wet. You may not even realize that you're making this common mistake. Washing your veggies is great, but not patting them dry before cooking can ruin a dish. When they're too wet, the water creates a steam which results in mushy food. By thoroughly drying them, your veggies will remain bright and crisp. Wet food can also be a danger when placed in a pan of hot oil. Before cooking your vegetables, place them on a clean dish towel or paper towel and pat them dry. This will help you get the most out of your meal and is worth the extra bit of time. Number 10. Cooking them the same way every time. When we're hungry, the easiest thing to do is cook the food the best way we know how. This is good for a while, but then it starts to get boring. Veggies can be cooked in so many ways. It will also help kids who don't like veggies very much decide how they like their produce best cooked and get used to a diverse menu. Number 11. Under-seasoning the vegetables. Each vegetable has its own unique flavor, but that doesn't mean you shouldn't add more. Salt and pepper are great, but they're not enough. Vegetables can be marinated in flavorful combinations of tamari, liquid aminos, broth, vinegar, and spices. They can be tossed in a mix of your favorite herbs and spices. By changing the flavor profile of the seasoning, you can take one vegetable, such as spinach, and cook it a dozen different ways, and each dish will taste unique, as well as amazing. Number 12. Not washing them properly before cooking. Conventionally grown, pesticide-laden vegetables like celery, spinach, sweet bell peppers, and tomatoes all made appearances on the Environmental Working Group's annual Dirty Dozen list. If you tend to quickly rinse these veggies or not wash them at all, you're likely ingesting chemical residues that can cause stomach pain, nausea, and diarrhea. The worst part is, these chemicals don't just come and go. They hide out in your fat cells until you go on a diet and start to lose weight. According to researchers, when the pounds start to come off, the chemicals come out of hibernation and shoot into the bloodstream, slowing your energy expenditure and metabolism. Even if you always buy organic, soak your veggies in a pot of water for 10 to 15 minutes before eating them. Then give them another quick rinse under some running water to make sure they're clean. So now that you're aware of the mistakes that you've been making when cooking vegetables, it's important to know which ones are the best for your health. As not all vegetables are created equal, get your answers here by finding out more about 9 of the most nutrient-dense foods on the planet, or learning about 8 healthy vegetables you should be eating and 8 you shouldn't. These two videos will surely help you pick up vegetables which are healthiest for you. Also, don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel. How many of these mistakes have you been making regularly? Let us know in the comment section below.